Let's just turn now to white cell disorders. Here, perhaps there may be a deficiency of white cells. That puts the patient at risk of infection because that is the major function of this class of blood cell. Now, low neutrophils goes under the term neutropenia. There are many causes for this. Sometimes it's a drug reaction. Sometimes it might be an infection itself. Or, of course, it could be seen as part of a general bone marrow problem. The normal neutrophil count is around 2 times 10 to the 9 per liter. But infection becomes a serious risk when that count falls below 0.5. And indeed, when we're giving chemotherapy to patients with cancer, we can often see it below 0.1. And here patients become at high risk of severe infection. Example on the right, you can see a patient with a very nasty infection of the skin. Lymphocytes can also be reduced in the count. That's called lymphopenia. That's slightly less common, but you can see it from, of course, immune deficiencies, and there's a wide variety of those. However, perhaps the biggest problem that we see with white cells is not when they're reduced, but when they're increased, and that, of course, is called leukemia. Let me just introduce you to leukemia. The word, interestingly, comes from Greek. It means white blood. I'm not up here to teach you classics, and I certainly wouldn't be able to, as I never learnt any. But that is an interesting phrase because it reminds us here that the tumor cells are in the blood. There's too many white cells in the blood and the bone marrow. Now, down the side of this graph here, we've got a range of different malignant diseases, leukemias and indeed lymphomas. And on the x-axis on the bottom here, you can see the age at which these arise, the median or average age at which these arise. I think there's two things to note. Firstly, most of these diseases are occurring in older people, perhaps nearly age of 70. And of course, that's common in most cancers. Cancers get more common as we age, because we acquire more mutations in our DNA. But secondly, notice two disorders which are seen in younger people. Near the top there, you can see acute lymphoblastic leukemia, the most common malignant disease in children. And you can see the median age is much reduced. And in the middle there, Hodgkin lymphoma. That's also often seen in younger people, perhaps around the age of 20. So those two disorders slightly stand out, and we'll discuss them in more detail in other lectures. So here we are, leukemia, and I've mentioned already, this means white blood, an increase in the white cell count in the blood. And hematologists, like many doctors and scientists, love to classify things into different groups. Leukemia is no different. There are four major types, two subdivisions. Acute leukemia and chronic leukemia. What do those terms mean? An acute leukemia develops quite rapidly. It's an aggressive disease. It can be fatal within weeks unless it's treated. Whereas chronic disease is slower growing. It takes more time to develop. It's less of a threat to the patient in the short term. Now, both acute and chronic leukemia can be further subdivided into lymphoid or myeloid. And this refers to the lineage of cells to which the leukemia belongs to. A lymphoid leukemia would be derived from B cells or T cells, whereas myeloid leukemia derives from many of those cells down the myeloid lineage, neutrophils, erythroblasts, megakaryocytes, and platelets. Now, we need to classify our leukemia into these four types because the treatments are very specific for each type. And these are improving every year. We're now getting very good results from the treatment of leukemia, but there's more that we need to do. Lymphoma. There's often confusion between the difference between leukemia and lymphoma, but it's really quite straightforward. Lymphoma is a disease in which the malignant white cells accumulate within the lymphoid tissue rather than within the blood. We have many lymph node groups around the body. 95% of our lymphocytes live within lymphoid tissue. Now, within lymphoma, the point you need to remember is that there are two main subtypes: Hodgkin lymphoma and non-Hodgkin lymphoma. Non-Hodgkin lymphoma includes many, many different subtypes of lymphoma. And the cell that distinguishes these two types is called the Reed-Sternberg cell. I'll explain that in much more detail in the lecture on lymphomas.